Good morning. I'm going to show you how I use this soft pastels in coloring books. This is also a requested video. So I have colored my little bird and my snail, and want to show you how I do it. Now you can do it in many ways, but what I like to do, it's like I got this small, this is just a lid, and I take my soft pastels and I choose, I start with like one color and then we take another one later on, and I just take this knife. You can use any knife and scrape some of the pigment off into my little lid. Like that. And I can take a different color and put it on the other side. So we. Oh my God, the dog and the cat goes again. Like this. A little pink. Now my pink is like a neon pink, so that's quite a massive color, but then I just have this small cotton bud. Oh my God.
Vad du gör? Låt vara.
We have this puppy that actually enjoys to flip my cats over. It actually is quite funny. She runs and then she jumps on their side and just pushes them over, so they fall. Then I just dip this cotton bud into the pigment and put it on the paper. When I have used a wax pencil or a pencil made mostly of wax, I have to try to avoid the parts that I have colored, or else the pigment will go on top of some of it, at least if it's very light, like this white parts on my highlights. I don't want them to turn yellow. So I have to just take it a little bit careful. I just push it on, wiggle it some. Everywhere where I want this. And just around there. That, and on the other side, or down here, I mean. And then I want to take my pink, just some. Now you can. Or I usually take like one cotton bud for each color. then it takes a little bit more yellow and just to pull it over. Now if I want it darker, I can either choose a darker color or I can just keep on adding in layers and building this up. The thing with soft pastels are that they are very easy to blend and to layer. Some more pigments, so I'll just scrape a little bit more off with the back side of my knife. Different patterns with your pastels too. You can go into circles, or you can make the leaks, or it's just up to how you want it to look. Build it up and work on it until it's all the way just like you want it. Now these are prismacolors colors, which are mostly wax based pencil. I did color this little fairy dragon up here with pastel polychromos. Now they are oil, so that means that my soft pastels will not attach themselves to my colorings. So like on this one, I'm careful not to get any pastels on the highlights, and if I do, I just erase it like really soft. I'm just wiping it off. But when you have oil pencils like this, the colors or the pigment from the soft pastels don't go on top, because you can't really put thing on top of oil. Another way to add pastels is just to scrape some powder off straight on the paper. So I have some light blue there. I'll take a new cotton bud. Then I just massage it onto my paper. Like this. And I go over the colorings. That's okay, because it just floats on top, since this is actually oil. And I can go over everything, and you see it will not get any color on my highlighted area. I will later make a video to explain the major difference between oil and wax pencils. And to try to show you all how you can use those pencils in a different way, and to take advantage of your oil or your wax pencil. I'm just adding this darker blue all the way around and pulling it a little bit into the lighter blue area. I got some dust there, so I just push that in. And I can use all of it up. So, now my little period dragon's got a little sky he can fly in. And there are no blue on him. So now some also puts the softpastels straight on the paper. Now that will leave some reeks, but you can do it. Just put it on like that, and now either take your finger or your cotton bud and just massage it out. Now I know many don't like to get messy, but that's okay by me. I kind of feel like I've actually been doing something if I have smushy hands. So that's, but that's just me. So you can just put it straight onto the paper too, if you want to. But that's not as easy to get even and smooth as if you take a plate or a lid or something and just scrape some color off and use a cotton bud or some use makeup sponges. That works very well too. So that was it. Some way to use soft pastels on backgrounds in coloring books. So I'll see you all next time. Bye.